Alright everyone, it's Shane here, and we're going to demo RuneWire 2. So, we're going to log in now, and it should be noted that your RuneWire 1 password will work on RuneWire 2. First thing you'll see once you log in is the new posting box. We've taken this and made it available on every page that has posts, so it's easier and quicker to make a post. We've got 4 post types this time: the text, the image, the video, and the event. Video and event being new to RuneWire 2. So, image works the same as before, so we're not going to talk much about that, except for the fact that it has a 3 megabyte file size limit this time to take into account for the release of RuneScape HD. Another thing that we've done with images is we've added a gallery mode, which lets you view pages of pictures in a more photo gallery type of mode, which users have expressed that they've wanted in the past for getting a quick bigger glance as to what is out there. Heading back to the traditional posting box, we'll play with the video. So in order to post a video, you basically need any YouTube URL. So I'm going to take this URL from How to Farm Part 2, in which Chief Snake covered how to herb farm and make a profit, along with bushes as well. So check that out on our YouTube channel. It's a simple matter of pasting in the YouTube URL. Any URL will work, even the localized country URLs. So you just enter in a description saying, this is how to herb farm and make a profit. And once you post it, it will appear with a thumbnail that we've seen on YouTube. And then once you click it, it will pop up in its own lightbox so you can view it, have your own viewing pleasure on the RuneWire site without leaving. Moving on, we have the events post. The events allow you to basically specify a time and place that something will be happening on RuneScape and then have it advertised accordingly. So I'm going to go actually and take this opportunity to show you the groups feature. Now, the groups feature is basically a nice and orderly way to organize your friends. So you need to have somebody added to your friends list before adding them to a group. So I've already made this group called God Wars Dungeon Early Sunday. So if I wanted to add or select members, I would just add them by clicking on them and then choose Edit Group. So then once the group is edited, we can go back to the main posting page and post an event. So it should be noted that we are going to be attempting an armadillo trip, so we'll just call it armadillo at night, location God Wars Dungeon outside the armadillo stronghold, which will be set to 1 a.m. on November 23rd, 2008. Armadillo. We will get a hilt. Then, of course, I want to send it to that group only, so we'll choose God Wars Dungeon Early Sunday, hit post, and this message will be sent to that group. You'll also notice that up here we have this rotating event box, which will show the most upcoming recent events that you are able to attend that you are able to view. So, as you can see, it shows here, it will just continue to roll through the events that are present. So, I should also just point out an enhancement in the singular posts, which there's two of them I want to show, specifically categories and mapping. So, let's just say I'm on a farming run and I see a nice patch that I never knew about before, particularly the spirit tree patch on etc., and I want to tell everybody about it. Just a little disclaimer, I actually did know about it beforehand, but I'm just using this for sake of demo. So we go spirit tree on etc. So we click the map button here, And then find etc. way, way up north. And then here it is, right here. Double click, close that. And there we go, that point has been saved. I also want to point out post categories, which is something, as it sounds, you can categorize your posts. So I'm just going to tag this one as farming. We have categories based on everything from achievements, mini-games, PvP, boss monsters, etc. Pretty much the works. So you can play with that later. Then once you send the post up to RuneWire, it will say Spiritreon, etc. Farming category. And then you can click this little map icon to show us the map. You can also filter certain posts by categories by selecting them. So if we choose farming, it will show us pretty much every farming post. And as you can see, since we're running demo software here, there's only one post. Then we can go back to all, and we'll see all the posts. Then, of course, you can filter as you would expect on RuneWire 1, personal, friends, incoming. And then the different types, text, images, videos, and events. So, with that said, why don't we take a look at the way the friends list has been reordered. If you mouse over friends, it will show everybody on your friends list with a maximum of 15, sorted by who is the most active recently. So if people were updated recently, they will appear near the top of the list. Otherwise, the ones who aren't will appear at the bottom. So, with that said, why don't we just head back to the main page. Oh, as you can see here, we have just received a new message from Paul, PFK99, so we're showing the incoming messages. So this is the way private messages will work. You'll get a notification, then you can see it, that it was sent. So, could you come and help me with a Kalphite Queen task? I've got a few hundred to kill. I know you're great with her. Maybe we can get a few change. Thanks, PFK. And as you can see, he put a map on it, which shows that this is where we're going to go down into the Kalphite lair. Thank you, Paul. Moving on from that, I want to show you a bit about the profiles, meaning the different options you have. We have privacy options in which you can display instant messages to everyone, friends, or nobody. Same goes for websites and links, your about info, and your RuneScape usernames. We also give you the option to display replies in stream, which will mean that pretty much every reply is listed as a separate post, but of course you won't be able to click on it. Then of course we also have Ajax loading, which means that the replies will load in beneath each post on the main page. Then there's also email notifications, so it can email you if you get a new private message or someone adds you to your friends list. Other profile information includes your about section, your time zone. Please be sure to set the right time zone, because that is never so much more important than it is now, with the fact that we have events and those are based on your time. We've also got instant messengers, which you can add from AOL, same as RuneWire 1. Websites and links, you can add more than one. RuneScape profiles, you can add individual ones, members, retired, or P2P, and then you can set one as your primary account. That will be displayed primary on your profile. And then, yeah, pretty much everything else here is the same. Also, I'd like to just point out one more quick feature before I let you go and play with RuneWire tomorrow when it's released. We have the to-do list. Basically, this will allow you to say stuff that you want to get done in RuneScape. So, for instance, if you're planning on buying something but you're not sure on the prices, you want to check the prices each time when you get on, so you can say check prices of party hats. Then hit add, and it will add it in. Let's add another one called, say, get 99 farming, which obviously is done. So you can just hit the little check mark and it will be complete. Then if you don't want to keep it anymore, just press the little X and it will give you confirmation as to whether or not you want to delete it. So with that said, I think it's time to say that if you have any questions about RuneWire 2, suggestions or comments, please contact us at runewire.com/ contact. Thanks, and that's all for today.